Hey everyone, welcome back. In this video, we're going to cover workload domains. We're coming to the tail end of this series, but all the interesting stuff is about to kick off again. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to get a Vera token, how to commission a host, how to create a network pool, and also how to then finally build a workload domain. All of this will be done via API primarily, but I'll also show you how to do it via the UI. Now, before all of that, I wanted to recap what a workload domain is and how it interacts with the rest of the SDDC. Now, picture this, you need workload, let's say web servers, all that sort of stuff that you need to build. However you choose to build them, they need to go somewhere. You don't typically put them in your management domain as that's reserved for management appliances. That's why you build the workload domain. Now, every time you build a workload domain, hopefully you remember this, you've got a set of hosts, but as part of that, you've also got vCenter and NSX that get spun up for at least the first workload domain. Now, any subsequent workload domains will then have a choice of whether reusing the same NSX, but will get its own vCenter, or building its own fresh set of appliances. Okay, now that that's the recap over, let's go into actually building it. First thing you need to do, get a bearer token. Any API functions need to have a bearer token so it can authenticate. It needs to go to V1 tokens. Username and password is your SSO admin account and password. Hit send on that and we'll get a Vera token back. There you go. And copy everything between the quotes. Okay, with that token copied, I'll open up a new request. We're going to create a network pool. Now to do that, we change the URI to V1 network pools. And then I'll change the method to post. Hit authorization, change it to Vera token and paste that token in there. Click back to body and we have to populate the JSON payload. I've pre-configured a JSON payload, which I'll make available to you. In it, you've got subnet mask, gateways, pools, VLAN IDs, MTU. Make sure all of this is relevant to your environment, and then we'll hit send, which will create the network pool for us. You can see the status down the bottom there is 201 created, which is a good sign. If we go back to SDDC Manager now, we should be able to check that it exists. And there it is, perfect. If we open it up, you can see everything that we configured is there as we put in the JSON payload. As always, I'll show you the UI variation. You go to network settings, create network pool, populate all the details, and then click save once done. Once you click save, you'll see the new network pool in the list, and that's all you need to do. We can use this now going forwards to commission hosts. That's what we're gonna do next. Click hosts, then click on commission hosts. You can read through this list, make sure everything is good. In my case, I'll select all and hit proceed. Now you've got two options. You can manually add each host individually, or you can use the import function and bulk add them, or we can also use the same JSON that you would use to import. As usual, I will pre-populate this JSON and make it available to you. This will help me bulk commission three hosts into the environment to build the workload domain. I'm gonna post this to the validations. Actually, look, that saying something is missing, it's unauthorized, so I need to go back, copy the bearer token in and put it into the authorization tab, which I'll do now. Okay, so now that's an internal server error. That's telling me there's an issue with the JSON. So I'll fix it up, come back, and we'll go continue on. I also wanted to show you how the API Explorer can be useful here. It shows you all the fields that we will need to be able to commission hosts. So I'll copy this stuff in, put it into the JSON, and use the fields that are required. Not all of them are required, and you'll see which ones as part of the example that I provide to you. Okay, with that properly configured now, you can see the validation is in progress. If I try to issue a GET to the validation, it'll tell me that it's successful, or hopefully it would have succeeded. There you go, succeeded. Now we can just remove the validations part of this and post and issue another request to start commissioning those hosts into SDDC Manager. So I'll hit send on that. There you go, in progress. Now we can track this via tasks in via API or just have a look at the tasks in SDDC Manager. There you go, the hosts. Host commissioning was successful. There you can see all the tasks that were done to commission the host as well. And they should show up in unassigned hosts. May need to refresh. Next, we're on to building a workload domain. Click on workload domains on the left, then hit the plus on the workload domain. VI workload domain, select the type of storage. We're going to use vSAN in this example and hit begin. Give it a name for the infrastructure and an organizational name. For lifecycle management, up to you if you want to use images. I'm not going to. Hit next, cluster name. I'll move through these details as quickly as possible. The FQDN reverse looks up and gets the IP for you, so make sure DNS for everything. Same with these fields as well. get all the passwords in. For the overlay networking, you want to make sure you've got the VLAN for your TEP network entered there, and then if you want to use IP pools or DHCP. In this case, I'm going to be using DHCP. Click next and then check your failures to toll rate. I've got three hosts, so I can do one. If I had more, I can do two. And if I had less, I could do zero, but I'm going to select one and I'm not going to use dedupe or compression. Check the hosts that you want to use for the workload domain. Hit next. These will be the ones we just commissioned. Then we want to enter all the license keys. Pick all the licenses, hit next once you're done. The next page is just the summary of object names, and then click finish to create. In this case, we're going to cancel this and we're going to repeat the same process using API. First thing we need to do is find all the usable hosts and the unassigned hosts. The URI up the top there will give us those results. Now we can do this via API or UI. I'll show you the API first. Now grab all the IDs. We should have three from the three hosts that we assigned. Copy them into a notepad document to keep them ready to go for later. The UI method is quite simple. You click on hosts, pick any host, just click on it. And at the top of the URL, you'll be able to see the host ID. You can do that for each host that you require. Just copy it and dump it into a file. This is the domain creation spec, or JSON, I should call it. This is where we'd place all those IDs that we just found and all the other configuration that we require to build the workload domain. Now, the API is more flexible than using the UI. The UI has very strict requirements. Let's pause the video right there. I wanted to show you this tool by an awesome community member that knows how difficult or challenging it can be to get these JSONs for the workload domain created correctly. He's come up with this tool that if you put in your inputs, it will generate and spit out the workload domain JSON for you. Now that is in the link below, but here it is in front of us as well. As you just saw, I got another token, or bearer token I should say, and we're going to post this to V1 Domains Validations Creations. We're validating the spec before we create it. There you go, that's now succeeded. To build the domain, now all we need to do is rip everything out after domains, so validations and so on, and send the exact same thing, and that will start building. This process, as usual, can be monitored via API. To do so, we go to V1 tasks and find the tasks. You can see that in the view there. The other way we can also monitor it is using the UI, which I'm not really going to show you. It's just a matter of going back into SDDC Manager. Okay, let's let that finish building. And there you have it. It says the task for creating workload domain is finished. If I open it up, you can see a whole heap of tasks that you, again, didn't have to do yourself. Imagine how much time you would have spent doing that. If I go into workload domains on the left there, oh, I'm already there, you can click on it. This is the workload domain context where you can see the summary, services, patches, host clusters, edge clusters, and so on. If you want to do any host or cluster activity, you need to come into this context, go into clusters, and then find all the hosts and whatever actions you're trying to do. Mostly removing hosts from the cluster, this is where you need to go. And stiff gets fairly self-explanatory. It'll show you what you've got configured specifically for this workload domain. Okay, quickly. So you can see a new vCenter and NSX deployed into the management domain. The new vCenter is attached or linked to the original vCenter using enhanced link mode. All the hosts are attached to the vCenter. It also has configured in the transport nodes or NSX. As you can see there, they're all successful. They've got tunnel endpoints. There's a compute manager, which is the vCenter, registered and up. All right, we're right at the end of this video. Hopefully you got something out of it. You should now know the process of creating a workload domain by UI and API. Now, to get to this point, you do need SDDC Manager, which I'll show you how to do in this video, as well as all the prerequisites and deploying the actual management domain first in this video.